Welcome to Sailing Trilleen. You join me on passage round Land's End from Falmouth to Kinsale Island. Trilleen rolled her way happily across the Celtic Sea in a passage that saw two dusks and one dawn. So the bin is being repurposed as the food bin for passage to Ireland, or to the Scillies, and possibly to Ireland. So in these food flasks are 2 meals of chickpea and tomato stew.
And I threw a few other things in there, like some pre-made pasta ready to go with hot water, some rice pudding, some tomato soup, some mackerel and some nuts.
I'm not a big fan of snacking on passage. I much prefer, I've discovered, to have a proper meal, or at least something that passes for a proper meal, like rice pudding, which gives you a lot more sustained energy for a long period, which is really what you need out there.
The rhyme of the ancient mariner, water, water everywhere, nor any drop to drink, is a major preoccupation. Not because Trilleen doesn't have enough water on board, but because at times it gets so busy on deck with traffic and sail changes that getting water out of the tank is taxing. A consequence of my spinal injury and suprapubic catheter is that getting dehydrated can have unpleasant consequences. So I make a point of getting water down my throat at every chance I can.
So, that's us around Land's End. We're through the transit between the Longship's Light and Wolf Rock. We've just gone around Carn Barn, which is a cardinal marking some rocks. And Trilleen and I are about to turn north to parallel the traffic separation scheme, or motorway for ships. And then, because the motorway is quite empty, we might cross it, rather than going all the way up to the top of it and then shooting across in unregulated sea. But at the moment, there's basically no traffic in the lane, so that sounds like a good thing to me, and we might as well get across, and then we can shape a course for Ireland.
Once Trilleen and I were across the TSS, with some help from a chat with friends, we opened out into the western approaches. That was a surprisingly emotional experience. The last time I was there, I was in a ship almost exactly 100 times heavier than Trilleen. With the wind in the northeast, Trilleen was reaching comfortably across the wind and sea, settling into a rolling gait at between 5 and 7 knots, which is a very satisfactory speed for a little boat and eats up the miles. Then, to my great joy, the dolphins paid a visit, squeaking their way up to Trilleen and, for a few moments, playing with the boat. I thought that was my lot for the trip, but it turned out that they popped back every 20 to 30 minutes, almost all the way to Ireland. A lot of the time I couldn't see them, but the sonar was clearly audible through the solid hull of Trilleen. I didn't touch the tiller from Falmouth to Kinsale approach. The hydrovane self-steering did it all. This mechanical servo pendulum wonder keeps the boat at the same angle to the wind, and so in between all round looks at the horizon, there was some time for eating, resting and reading.
We are 110 miles from the initial fix at Kinsale. Trilleen is storming along. She's doing 6 knots in a beautiful, beautiful wind. 16 knots apparent right on the beam, so about 16 knots true actually as well. And the sea is slight at the most. And she's just shouldering her way through it. I actually took the last reef out to give her a bit more power. And at the moment she's handling it really well, so I've just left it. But if it rises any more, I might have to drop it a bit.
Dawn at sea comes up first gently, then quite suddenly all at once. As the second morning on passage broke, the sea conditions were still pretty comfortable. One more night would see Trilleen anchored at Kinsale, a night that would become progressively less comfortable as we together closed the Irish coast. A mixture of sea breaking over Trilleen from stem to stern, increased amounts of traffic, and a gas field being dismantled made for increasingly high workload at a point when my resources were drained by a very, very bad decision not to get as much rest as I could during the day.
Ian, welcome to Kinsale Yacht Club.
Thank you very much.